For 31 years, environmentally sensitive buildings, projects, and initiatives have been recognized by Valley Forward with its Environmental Excellence Awards. Valley Forward, in partnership with SRP, announced the 2011 award winners over the weekend, and here with a look at some of the winners is Diane Brossart. She's president of Valley Forward, and Laurie Singleton of Salt River Project. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us on Horizon.
Thank you.
All right, Diane, what is Valley Forward? What is Valley Forward?
Valley Forward is a 42-year-old environmental public interest group, primarily business-based. Brings business and civic leaders together to convene dialogue on issues relating to the environment and sustainability and how we grow, and hopefully that we grow in harmony with the natural environment.
And how did these awards get started?
These awards were started in 1980. It started kind of as a buildings and structures show. It was more about the architectural design, and eventually it grew to be, you know, just on sustainability, and the categories got broader, and we started looking at things like public art and technology and education, and now they're the Academy Awards of the environmental community.
They certainly are. And SRP has been involved for how long now?
Yes, this was our 10 years as being the primary sponsor for the Environmental Excellence Awards. And it's a great way for us to be able to showcase what others in the Valley are doing as it relates to sustainability.
And as far as now judging the awards, who judges? How does that work?
We get an expert panel of judges with people that represent each of the award categories. Our lead judge this year was Christine Tenike from Tenike Landscape Architecture. And so then we had a couple of architects, a couple technology experts. And so there's 9 judges total, so that we have an even, you know, when you vote,
yeah.
You get a clear winner.
Sure.
And it took place over 2 days. We had over 130 entries this year, so there were a lot of entries.
And what are you looking for here? What's the criteria? What is given more weight maybe than others?
I think it depends on the project and whether it's technology or if it's architecture or art. I mean, each of the categories has specific criteria as it relates to that award. So each one is judged on the criteria for that.
And how many different categories we got going here?
Well, there are 6 broad-based categories, but 21 inside of that. And really, we're looking at what sets the bar. You know, what is the best in each category? And for that honor, the best in each category, we give the first place Crescordia Award.
Which means?
Which is a Greek term. You should know, Ted. You did a great job of emceeing the show this year.
Well, you're right about that, but I don't know.
This is a test.
Yeah, I don't remember what Crescordia means.
It means to grow in harmony. So from this perspective, it's to grow in harmony, taking the built environment and marrying it with the natural environment. And how does that look? And how does it be sustainable for the long term?
Before we get to the winners now, are we seeing more entries, more folks, individuals, organizations, groups getting involved in this, at least getting involved in projects that would be recognized by Valley Forward?
Absolutely. Each year we see more and more projects that are participating. And each year, as Diane said, it just sets the bar as it relates to what others are doing and what they can do. That's one of the things that we really want to look at, is how can other organizations take what these projects have done and apply that to their own project.
All right, let's take a look at some of the winners now. And I want to start with the biggie, the President's Award. This is an interesting award because it's a road. And you wouldn't think environmental excellence would be awarded to a highway.
Intuitively, you would not compare a roadway project with an environmental award. However, this project, US 60 Gonzales Pass, really exemplifies environmental stewardship in so many ways. It's a highway widening project from 2 to 4 lanes, and they took painstaking care to protect and preserve the environment around the project. In fact, they did a plant inventory, and cactus salvage replanting plans were completed for more than 35,000 saguaros, ocotillo, barrel cactus. I mean, that's just amazing all by itself. They took 150,000 cubic yards of earth and from failed slopes and replaced it to get the natural lay of the land to return it to its natural state.
And did I see a tortoise crossing
you
there?
Did. They
Isn't
had a tortoise
something?
Crossing.
So where exactly is this? Is it between Apache Junction and like Boyce Thompson Arboretum? Is it somewhere out? Where is this?
You know, I'm not.
Superior, on the way up to Superior.
So it's up on the way up to Boyce Thompson.
Right, right.
Okay,
exactly.
So when you're up there and you think things are looking awful pretty, it's because you're on a Gonzales Pass.
Right. So what it does is it's really been a sustainable cultural feature for some of those little mining communities and small towns in that area, and protects the Arizona wildlife at the same time. So it's a pretty remarkable project.
All right, let's go to our next winner is the Intel Ocotillo campus. And this was for general environmental stewardship?
Yes, they received a couple of awards. One was for their general environmental stewardship as it relates to everything they do in their businesses at the Ocotillo campus. One of the things that we know is important is engaging employees as you think about sustainability, and they've done an outstanding job of engaging their employees. Another thing that they've done is they have a project that's actually the first in the world, and not too many of us can claim a project's the first in the world, but that relates to their Ocotillo campus and their being the first company to receive a LEED Silver Award for a project that's already built. And so it took them about 3 years to really demonstrate and document all of their sustainable practices. But obviously, they did a great job, and they're very happy about this award, as are all of us. I think we can give them a good round of applause for their efforts in this regard.
All right, very good. We'll keep it moving here. Now, it's not just roads and buildings, but educational programs recognized as well.
Environmental education has been at the heart and soul of Valley Forward since its inception in 1969. We need to create future stewards of the environment. So we're all about, teaching and mentoring. And the city of Glendale has a wonderful program called Conservation and Sustainable Living. And they're educating residents and businesses on ways to implement environmental practices. And they have given away free at their environmental fairs and whatnot 6,300 devices, like programmable thermostats, energy efficiency shower heads, and all kinds of gadgets. They also have Watt Watchers, which is a science-based, regionally focused energy education program for teachers that they're doing. They're doing a lot in terms of Zeroscape. They have a wonderful, have you been out to the city hall there?
The tree trail?
They have a whole Zeroscape garden with, information on what is planted there and how it saves water. And so they're promoting energy conservation and water conservation through that project as well.
All right. And that's Glendale.
That's Glendale.
And over in Phoenix now, they were recognized for public art. What does that mean?
Yes, they have 150 public art projects that really are looking at promoting sustainability. And some of the projects that they've done include the Arizona Falls, Sunny Slope Canal Demonstration, Highline Canal. And they actually were, this Office of Arts and Culture was founded more than 25 years ago. And today, one of the interesting things about these public art projects is you typically have engineers working with artists, working with landscape designers. And if you think about that, it's not always the you would not think the outcome would be what it is, but they've done a great job of melding all of these interests together and creating projects that are really showcasing public art in the city of Phoenix.
And we recognize that down here near the,
right
the Channel 8
you,
Studios.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we saw some of those canals, the waterfall canals, which are just beautiful there along, I think, Indian School in Scottsdale.
Right. 56th Street. That's an SRP project.
Great stuff.
Using art to create a sense of place and a gathering space for people is really important to creating vibrant, livable cities. They definitely make an impact.
Okay, so we've gone from Glendale to Phoenix, and now we're going to
Chandler.
Yeah, and that city hall down there in Chandler, that's a nice looking building.
That is a spectacular building, and I know that from having gone there a couple times. It's a wonderful work to LEED Gold certification. LEED is Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design sort of standards for an environmental building, and they well exceeded in their City Hall project, which also includes office space, a public TV studio, much like this only, art gallery, and the council chambers, of course, is in there. And I had the pleasure, they have a walkway there, and I was at an outdoor meeting in the middle of the summer, and you feel a breeze in the breezeway because they've built a microclimate, and some of the techniques in the building that they've instituted have really made a difference.
And overall, downtown development in Chandler was recognized as well. I mean, they're doing things.
They really are. I was proud of Chandler. They rose. They've got a couple Crest Gordias. Yeah, their downtown redevelopment, where they're creating a walkable, viable, vibrant city.
And in Scottsdale, now we're moving over to Scottsdale here because The bridge that gets a lot of conversation going, the Solari Bridge and the plaza there as well, that was recognized too.
Yes, absolutely it was. It received a Criscordi Award, two Criscordias in fact. And one of the interesting things about this is there are these two 66-foot pylons, which I think you can see here, mm-hmm. and they are tilted back from the bridge structure at a 10-degree angle and set exactly 6 inches apart to create a sundial effect for marking the precise times of the solstice each year. So we'll have to all be sure and be out there on the solstice. another thing that's very interesting about this project, it was designed by Paolo Solari, and while he's been designing bridges for 60 years, this was the first one that was commissioned and completed, and he's actually 91 years old.
Indeed.
And he was at the grand opening for that project, which Lori and I attended in the city of Scottsdale. It was good to see
something that he has designed find fruition.
That's right.
After all those years. White Tank Branch Library.
Beautiful.
A library. This thing's out in the desert really kind of by itself.
It's kind of out there, but it is a magnificent building. Not only architecturally, it's beautiful, but has a number of sustainable design features, energy efficiency, water conservation, passive solar, even the basins and drywall filters infiltrate 100% of the stormwater back into the ground. So it's a gorgeous facility out there. It's beautiful. Makes me want to go out there. That's the thing about these projects and going through the awards program.
Sure does.
Really inspiring.
and for those who just want to look for any excuse to go to IKEA, apparently they were winners as well.
Yes, they are, and they're a great corporate citizen as you think about all the things that they're doing at their facility in Tempe. They were actually the third IKEA project out of eight today. There are eight completed solar projects, and you can see the solar on the rooftop here. The solar helps offset their energy usage at the facility, and that's a pretty large array, as you can see, covering most of the rooftop. Some of the other things that IKEA does at the store is really encourage recycling, and they allow ways for the community to bring in their bags and their bottles and their cans and their light bulbs to help recycle them. And also there's a kiosk at the store that shows what the solar energy and how that works and how much it's producing, because you actually can't see that system from when you're walking into the store.
Sure. There are so many other winners here. We don't have enough time to get to all of them. But it strikes me that last year, it just seemed like there were a lot of things going on. And you kind of wonder, what's going to happen next year? Will there be enough next year? And goodness knows, there was enough. Does it surprise you sometimes that every year there's this much going on in the Valley?
I'm always not so surprised, because I've seen it 20 years now at Valley Forward, but I'm always impressed and always by the difference in the projects, the uniqueness of them, the various different categories, the many project participants. That is always very inspiring and good to see.
And to have company, U-Haul was recognized there, and again, IKEA was recognized, and Macy's was recognized during the awards ceremony as well. That surprised you to see some of these bigger businesses getting on board with sustainability?
Actually, it did. It was the first year that we'd seen so many businesses take away these top awards, and a lot of time it's the cities and the municipalities, but this year we really did see a tremendous effort by these businesses who are all looking at sustainability as they think about running their business every day.
And for next year, we'll probably see something that footbridge over Tempe Town Lake, that seems like it's a nice looking thing. But it's got to be environmentally sensitive.
The projects are evaluated on their environmental qualities, yes.
So it's architecture and sensitivity.
Correct. And I like that you're thinking ahead. You're looking at the Valley now and you're thinking about these.
I'm trying to be a forward thinker.
So we're doing our job.
Yes. All right. Well, next year we'll try to get you back with some more. But it was really fascinating. It is inspiring, isn't it, to see. I mean, people look at the Valley. Arizona's got its problems, and goodness knows we talk about them here on the program. But it's nice to see some good things happening out there.
It's wonderful. We had 600 people come to the banquet.
I heard that the host did a particularly fantastic job. Is that accurate?
Yeah. We'd like to invite him back next year.
Really? I'll see if I can contact him. Good to have you both here.
Thank you
so much, and congratulations again on a wonderful ceremony.